Hi, this is Freddy from Switzerland with another knife review. Today we're going to take a look at another knife from Claude Dazome, a manufacturer of premium French cutlery. And today the knife we're going to take a look at is a very special one with a very special and interesting story behind it. And here in front of you see all the four different versions that are available of the Compostelle model. And the special thing about these knives is that each of these four models represent one trail of St. James. So all the four ways of St. James out of France to Compostelle are listed on the blades itself, and you also get different handle materials. Here at the bottom, you see the version that I have here and that we're going to take a look at later on. And you see here all these stations inside France are listed here. So it starts at Arles on this route, then goes to Montpellier, Castres, Toulouse, Auch, and ends in Compostelle as all the four trails will. So this is one version you can get with the olive wood handle scales. And here you have the second version that starts at Vézelay and goes also all the way to Compostelle and has rosewood handles. All of them have X50 CRMOV 15 blade steel. And here at the top you have a third way that starts at Tours and goes all the way to Compostelle and has nice oak wood handles. And at the top, if I can show you that here, you have the fourth way that starts at Le Puy and goes all the way to Compostelle as well. And this has very, very beautiful horn handles as well. So really nice concept behind these knives. So we have a representation of a pilgrimage knife that also is a very good knife on its own, as you're going to see later on in the video. And I think they really have a nice concept going on and they executed it very well. I really like all the four versions of the Compostelle. Now let's take a look at the real knife right here. And as I said before, mine one is the version with the olive wood handle scales and the trail that starts at Arles, as you can see here. So let's open it up and take a look at the specs as always first. So we have an overall length of 23 centimeter or 9 inches. So it's a pretty long and big knife, especially for a pocket knife, and that gives you a blade length of 10.5 centimeters or 4.1 inches, and a handle length of 12.5 centimeters or 4.9 inches. So a really nice large folder here by Claude Dazome. Now let's take a look at the weight of the Compostelle by Claude Dazome. And this large knife only weighs 105 grams or 3.7 ounces, so really an achievement, quite lightweight for the overall size of this knife. And that is of course because it uses very nice wood handle scales that also do not weigh as much and have chosen to use capable but not overly thick steel liners for the liner lock. So really nice overall construction, very, very good weight for the overall size. Now let's take a closer look at the 4.1 inch long X50 CRMOV 15 steel blade of the Compostelle model by Claude Dazome. And you can see here you have a nice pronounced drop point blade shape that nearly is a spear point blade shape right here. A nice satin finish blade and also a full flat grind here on the blade, which makes it a very nice slicer and really good looking blade in my opinion as well. And you also can see all the markings here on the blade. So you have Claude Dazome and Le Chemin de Saint-Jacques, which stands for the Ways of Saint James. And you also can see this is 100% made in France. Also a very nice marking that stands for quality manufacturing. And as you saw before, here on the other side you have the Trail of Saint James here with the different stations in France itself. So here you have Arles, Montpellier, Castres, Toulouse, Auch, and at the end Compostelle as the final destination. So really, really nice and useful blade shape in my opinion. The X50 CRMOV 15 steel is commonly used by Claude Dazome in a lot of his folders, and it's a steel that is often used in the premium German kitchen cutlery because of its high rust resistance. It also has an adequate edge retention and is easy to resharpen. So for a knife that you are actually going to use, and especially for a food preparation or a backpacking knife, so you can cut bread because of the length of the blade very easily and also to cut fruit up and some dried meat and stuff like that. I think it's a very nice blade overall because you get a long blade, and the nice rust resistance also helps if you don't have the time or the means to clean your blade right away after cutting up some fruit or anything like that. So that should be no problem with the steel that they have chosen here. So overall, nice steel choice, and because the knife is that lightweight and has a certain size, I think a backpacking blade, or as they are intended as a pilgrimage blade, this is a really, really nice overall design and also quite a nice steel choice. Now let's take a short look at the blade strength of the Compostelle model here. So you can see the tip is quite a precise and thin tip, so you can do some detailed work with it, but it's certainly not a knife that you should pry, even though it comes with a quite a nice 3 millimeter thick spine, so it's not flimsy at all. It has a certain amount of strength, but the tip gets to a very fine point, so no prying with this one. But for food preparation and also maybe fine carving tasks, this knife is certainly up for that task, in my opinion. Now let's take a look at the handle design and construction on the Compostelle right here. So you can see you have the gorgeous olive wood handle scales here on both sides, and your Torx screw construction. So you can take the knife apart if you have to. You have also quite large body screws, as you can see here, so you're not going to strip them out if you take the knife apart a couple of times. You also see here that you don't have a flow-through construction. You have a stainless steel backspacer over the whole length of the handle right here. Then you have a very nice proprietary and decorative pivot screw right here, the scallop of St. James, very fitting theme on the pivot screw here on the presentation side. Very, very nice looking touch, in my opinion. And on the other side, you have the proprietary fastener as well. But you actually get the tool to adjust the pivot point with the knife right from Claude Dauthon, which is a really nice feature. And I would like to see all manufacturers that use proprietary hardware to include the wrench that goes with it in the package right away, so you can adjust it as a user. Here you get the wrench with it. It looks like this. It's the same that you get on the RLT model, so you can just get in there and adjust the pivot screw without any problem because they provide you with the wrench right here. Other than that, you also see that the knife is a liner lock, so nice modern addition here. So you have a locking blade, even though it's a two-handed deploying knife. Of course, there is no thumb stud or flipper on this knife, but you get the liner lock for additional safety, and it's a quite nice liner lock. The lockup is perfect, no up and down, no side-to-side play whatsoever. And the liner lock is also quite easy to disengage because it protrudes quite a bit from the actual olive wood handle scale, so there's absolutely no problem to get to the liner lock and disengage it and close the blade. And it's also jimped as well, but I really like the fact that it's easy to disengage, but it protrudes a little bit too much for my taste. As you can see here, it really protrudes into the finger trail right here, and that creates a little bit of a hot spot when you're holding the knife like this. So your pointer finger knuckle is just rubbing up against the liner lock because it protrudes a little bit too much for my taste. It could be a little bit less pronounced for me, but it's really easy to disengage because of that. So other than that, you also can see you have stainless steel liners which are not skeletonized, and the locking liner is quite a bit thicker than the non-locking one, which I really like, and that also shows you some attention to detail and that they know how to make a large but lightweight and still very strong knife by cutting down on the weight where it is not necessary. So really nice overall handle construction, very, very large handle, so you have absolutely enough place to put your hand. Even if you have a lot bigger hands than mine, you should fit it on the Compostelle right here without any problem. It certainly misses some jimping here on the spine of the blade, but for the intended use, I can see why they chose not to jimp the spine right here. You can also see that all the tolerances here are quite nice. You have no gaps, nothing like that. Everything is fitted very, very well and rounded. Also, the handle feels extremely nice. Very ergonomic design, except the large protruding part here of the liner lock is a little bit digging into your finger, as I said before. Other than that, I really like the handle design and construction here on the Compostelle by Claude Dazo. Now let's take a closer look at the centering action and deployment of the knife. So you can see here that the centering is not perfect. It's quite a bit off to the right, but it's not rubbing against the liner, so no big deal for me. Absolutely no chance of damaging the blade here with this centering. You also can see the nice fit and finish at the butt hand here of the handle. No gaps, everything fits exactly where it should. Regarding the deployment of the knife, of course you can do it two-handed, and it's a very, very smooth deploying knife. So really nice work here in the pivot point by Claude Dazon. But with a little bit of practice, you can also do it one-handed. Of course, it's not a very fast deploying motion, but it certainly works because the blade protrudes quite a bit from the handle here in the lower parts. So you can grip it with your thumb and your index finger and rotate it out a little bit and then do the rest with your thumb like that. So that shouldn't be a big issue. But of course, it's not a fast deploying knife, not waveable, nothing like that. But I think for the intended purpose, it's a really nice deploying and also a really smooth knife they built here by Claude Dazon. And I really like the overall fit and finish and workmanship that you really see here in the Compostelle model. Very well done overall. Now let's take a look at the sharpness of the Compostelle model by Claude Dazon here. I now had this knife for a couple of months and took it out on some backpacking trips and mostly did, as I said before, food prep with it, a little bit of carving. So let's see how the X50 CRMOE 15 steel held up. So it's not as sharp as it came out of the box, as you can see here certainly, but it still cuts the paper quite nicely. So I have stropped it once since I got it, but I think the sharpness here is still quite impressive after all that use. And you can see here that it still can cut paper quite easily. So overall, the X55 is certainly no super steel, but I think its features or its specs really fit the intention of this knife with the backpacking and the food prep in mind, as a lot of French knives have. So overall, I think for the intended purpose, a good steel. Now let's come to the size comparisons I like to do. First off, is more of a material-based comparison, and also because of the place of manufacturing. So we have the Miguel Nieto Wolf, which also has gorgeous olive wood handle scales and is also made in Europe. So really nice comparison material-wise, but size-wise, the Compostelle absolutely dwarfs the Wolf model right here. So this is just a short comparison because of the materials used, but both of them are excellent knives and have very, very nice materials. So the next comparison I have for you is from the same company. It is the Claude Dazon RLT, which I have previously reviewed. Also a very, very nice and also quite large French folder here, more elegant in the overall execution and also a little bit more pricey. Really, really nice work of art here, the RLT by Claude Dazon. You can also see here the comparison in the thickness, quite similar as well, but this knife is considerably heavier because of the stainless steel bolsters and the stainless steel backspacer as well, and the very thick liners. As you can see here, they really, really did make a quite a hefty knife here with the RLT, but a really, really gorgeous one in my opinion. So size wise you can see here they are quite close, but the Compostelle model still dwarfs the RLT, as you can see here. A really, really big knife. The next comparison I have for you is also a slip joint folder, but a more modern interpretation of it, and it's actually made in Bulgaria. And a lot of people do certainly know now which knife I'm going to show, and it is the Manly Comrade. A very, very nice knife here. Really cool overall design for a slip joint folder in a modern interpretation. So you have two color G10 scales that are grooved here. I have the blue and black version, and you have a nice D2 blade steel that comes razor sharp out of the box, and you also get a pocket clip, which of course the RLT or the Wolf and even the Compostelle right here do not have. And you can see size wise it is still quite a bit smaller than the Compostelle. I also did a review here on the Comrade, so if you want to get a little bit more information about it, please check out the review I did, and you will find all the information right there. And the last comparison I have for you is the most modern one, a knife that certainly a lot of people know, but I think for the overall design it has a little bit of similarity with the Compostelle, and it is the Boker Quaken with custom scales by Coscadi. Really, really love these scales, and it also has a glow-in-the-dark backspacer here in the end. And you can see here also a thickness comparison, so the Compostelle is quite a bit thicker even than the Quaken here. But I think you can see here the similarities. Both of them are quite straight designs and quite slim designs, so that is why I chose the Quaken here. But even though the Quaken is quite a big knife in my opinion, it's quite a bit smaller than the Compostelle. So I think in this size comparison you really could get a feel that the Compostelle is quite a large knife. Now let's talk about value and price and come to a final conclusion about the Compostelle by Claude Dotton. And to get yourself your own Compostelle, you're going to pay around 70 to 80 euros. Depending on where you get it, you're going to find a link to my recommended retailer in the description box. And I think for that price, you really get a pretty nice knife. You have a very cool and interesting story behind it. You have a good steel for the intended purpose. You have very, very gorgeous olive wood handles or some other handle materials. Depending on the version you are going to choose, you can have rosewood, oak wood, or even the horn model, which I personally really like. You have nice attention to detail and some really nice custom features, like here the scallop of St. James and also the printing of the way of St. James here on the blade. It's really a feature that quite spoke to me. You also have a very nice and reliable liner lock system, so you have a nice, secure and safe knife to use. You have a long blade in a very lightweight package, in my opinion, with the 3.7 ounce weight that this knife carries with its very long 4.1 inch blade. So a really capable and lightweight knife with a little bit of a knock on the ergonomics because of the quite large protruding locking liner, which makes it easy to disengage but digs a little bit in your index finger right in the choil. But overall, I think it's a really nice 100% made in France knife that really looks pretty nice and also has its place in a backpacking environment, in my opinion. Really nice food prep knife with its blade design, steel and everything else. And I really like that they featured a liner lock here in this design and didn't just go with a slip joint mechanism that they often do. So overall, I really like this knife. I think it's a really great design and a really nice story behind the conception of this knife. So that was my review of the Claude Dotton Compostelle. I hope you liked it. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions about this knife or anything else I showed or talked about in the video, please leave it in the comments. I will try to answer you there. And if you want to see more of these knife, gun and gear reviews, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.